Hello friends, most welcome to my YouTube channel Maths by Samit Deshmukh. So in this video we are discussing how to find out general solutions of trigonometric equation. So here these three formulas means sin theta is equal to 0, cos theta is equal to 0, tan theta is equals to 0. These three trigonometric equations are given to us and their general solutions are also given here. Now the proof of these three important formulas is not given in our textbook. Just these formulas are given as an what? Remark. So we are also not wasting time to prove these formulas. We are able to prove it, but now we are not wasting our time to prove it. But we will try to understand how we have got this result. So see here, sine theta is equals to 0 implies that theta is equal to n pi. So try to understand the meaning of first result. Value of sine theta is 0 implies that theta is equal to n pi, where n belongs to z. Z is the notation used for set of integer. So which are the integers here? Set of integers contain which element, which numbers? 0, 1, 2, 3, continuing this way. On this side, negative numbers are there, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and so on. These are nothing but what? Integers. Now here from this graph we can observe that when the value of sine theta will be equals to what? 0. So we are trying to find out value of some unknown angle theta, where the value of sine theta is what? 0. Here just simply we can observe that sine theta is 0 at theta is equals to what? 0. Sine theta is equals to 0 when theta is equals to what? Pi. Observe that this graph touches x-axis, and at this point the value of y coordinate is equal to what? 0. Again the value of theta is equals to 0 at what? 2 pi. Continuing this way, we can say that theta will be equals to 0 at 3 pi, 4 pi. Okay. Now, again, if you will observe negative side, this sine theta is 0 at minus pi, minus 2 pi, minus 3 pi, continuing this way. So, means here we will get minus pi, minus 2 pi, continuing this. These are the values of theta, where the value of sine theta is equals to what? 0. So instead of writing all these result in this form, just simply we are able to write this result as what? Theta is equal to n pi. And here we are saying that n means what? Here n is nothing but coefficients of pi. N is nothing but what? Coefficient of pi. And this n belongs to integer, means it takes the values from set of integer. So which are integer? Let us begin with 0. If I am substituting here, n is equal to 0 into pi, 0, means we are getting this solution. If we are substituting n is equal to 1, 1 into pi is equal to pi, means we are getting second solution. In the same way, if we are substituting n is equal to 2, 2 into pi is 2 pi, then 3 pi, continuing this way. If we are considering negative numbers, say minus 1, minus 1 into pi will be minus pi, minus 2 into pi will be minus 2 pi. In this way, this expression represents all the solution of this trigonometric equation. Simply, this all the solution we have expressed in terms of this expression. And here n takes the values from what? Z. And z is nothing but what? Set of integer. Hope all of you have got here. Sine theta is 0 implies that theta is equal to what? N pi. So you have to remember this as an important formula, because these theorems or these formulas we are using while solving the example. So what first important reason we have got here? What is the general solution of first trigonometric equation? Sine theta is equal to 0. Its general solution is theta is equal to what? N pi. In the same way, let us discuss about the general solution of second trigonometric equation, that is cos theta is equal to 0, implies that theta is equals to what? Theta is equal to 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. Now n is what? Integer. Now try to understand here, n is nothing but what? Integer. So all of you know these integers. If we are multiplying to this integer by what? 2, then what result we will get? Can I say that we will get even integers? Yes, because if we are multiplying to any integer by 2, say if we are multiplying to 1 by 2, 1 2s are 2. Again, if we are multiplying to 2 by 2, 2 2s are 4. If we are multiplying to 3 by 2, 3 2s are what? 6. Means if we are multiplying by 2 to this integer, we will get what? Even integer. And if we are adding 1 in this even integer, the result will be what? Even plus 1 will be definitely what? Odd. किसी भी even integer में अगर हम 1 add करेंगे तो हमें क्या मिलेगा? ऑड इंटीजर मिलेगा. ओके, सो 2n प्लस 1 रिप्रेजेंट व्हाट? ऑड इंटीजर. एंड इफ यू ऑब्जर्व हियर, मल्टीपल ऑफ दिस पाई बाय 2, इज इट ऑड इंटीजर? एंड इफ मल्टीपल ऑफ पाई बाय 2 इज ऑड इंटीजर मीन्स व्हाट? 1, 3, 5. If the multiple of pi by 2 is odd integer, at that time, what result we are getting? Value of cos theta is equal to 0. Just we are able to understand this result from this graph of cos. So here we can observe that value of cos is 0. When the value of cos is 0, if at what? Pi by 2. At what is the multiple of pi by 2 here? Nothing is there means 1 is there. Here cos theta is 0. And what is the coefficient of pi by 2? Is it 3? 3 is it odd number? Here coefficient of pi by 2 is what? 5. 5 is what? Odd. Means if pi by 2 is odd multiple, means when the cos theta is 0, at odd multiple of pi by 2, means if coefficient of pi by 2 is odd integer, at that time value of cos theta is equal to 0. Observe on this side also, here the value of cos theta becomes what? 0. And what is the value of what is the coefficient of pi by 2? Is it minus 1? Here what? Minus 3. Here what? Minus 5. Means cos theta is 0 at odd multiple of pi by 2, and this odd multiple we are expressing by what? 2n plus 1, where n takes the values from set of integer. So in this way we have got second formula to find out general solution of which trigonometric equation? Cos theta is equals to 0. In the same way we have got the result of what? Tan theta is equal to 0. When the value of tan theta is equals to 0, if theta is equal to what? N pi. In the same way we are able to construct the graph of what? Tan theta is equals to 0. And observing that graph, we can say that value of tan theta is 0 at theta is equals to what? N pi. Otherwise, this tan theta is equals to 0, can I write tan theta as sin theta upon cos theta? Yes, sin theta upon cos theta, which can be written as cos on this side will get multiplied with 0. 0 into cos is what? 0. On this side remaining term is what? Sin theta is equal to 0. Means after simplifying this expression, what result we are getting here? Sin theta is equal to 0. But sin theta is equals to 0 implies that theta is equal to, from first result, sin theta is equal to 0 implies that theta is equal to what? N pi. In this way, tan theta is equal to 0 implies that theta is equals to N pi. This is the proof of what? Third important formula to find out general solution of trigonometric equation. Okay, so in this way we have got three important formula. Ye formulas aapki learn honi chahiye. What is the first formula? Sin theta is equal to 0 implies that theta is equal to n pi. Second formula says that cos theta is equal to 0 implies that theta is equal to 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. 2n plus 1 means what? Odd multiple of pi by 2. Then third is tan theta is equal to 0 implies that theta is equals to what? N pi. So these three formulas are given as an what? Remark in our textbook. So that's why we are not going to prove it. Now total six theorems are given to us in our first article. What is the first article of this chapter? Trigonometric equation. So let us try to these six important theorems. These theorems are nothing but what? Formulas to find out general solution of the trigonometric equation. Now observe the first theorem. In this case, we are going to prove that the general solution of trigonometric equation sin theta is equal to sin alpha is theta is equals to n pi plus minus 1 raised to power n into alpha, where n belongs to z, means n takes the values from set of what? Integers. So consider the given trigonometric equation sin theta is equals to sin alpha. So as it stands, we have three important formulas to find out general solution of trigonometric equation. Making the use of these three formulas, let us try to prove or let us try to find out the general solution of this trigonometric equation. So here let us simplify this trigonometric equation. Sin theta, keep it as it is. Plus term on this side will become what? Minus. Minus sin alpha is equal to 0. See, this is trigonometric equation. You have studied some method to find, to solve the equation. Just consider quadratic equation. One of the method to solve the quadratic equation is what? Factorization. Whenever we are solving any equation, our priority is to factorize that equation. So in this case also we are trying to find out factors of this trigonometric equation, and same method we are applying while solving the example also. Okay, So now here sine theta minus sine alpha means this term is in the form of what? Factorization formula. What is our factorization formula? Sine C minus sine D is equals to 2 cos C plus D upon 2 into sine C minus D upon 2. Let us apply this factorization formula to find out factors of this trigonometric equation. Here C means what? Theta. D means what? Alpha. So according to this formula, what we'll get here? 2 cos C plus D means theta plus alpha upon 2 into sine C minus D. C means what here? Theta. D means what? Alpha upon 2 is equal to 0. Now here we have got the factors. Now product of this factor is equal to 0 means one of them is 0. First factor is definitely non-zero. So means either second factor is 0 or this third factor is 0. Means here we can say that cos theta plus alpha upon 2 is equal to 0 or sine theta minus alpha upon 2 is equal to 0, isn't it? Now if you observe this expression, is it in the form of cos theta is equal to 0 and this is in the form of sine theta is equal to 0, and already we have the formulas to find out general solution of which trigonometric ratio? Sine theta is equal to 0 and cos theta is equal to 0. Means solving this trigonometric equation, we have converted them in the form of this formula. So now we are applying this formula. So first write down, we know that what is the first formula? Sine theta is equals to 0 implies that theta is equals to n pi, and cos theta is equals to 0 implies that theta is equals to what? 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. So let us make the use of these two formulas to solve this equation. Now this term is in the form of what? Cos theta is equals to 0, means it is in this form. And what is this general solution? Theta is equals to, but what is the value of theta here? So theta is nothing but theta plus alpha upon 2, isn't it? Instead of theta, here theta is theta plus alpha upon 2. On that side, what we will get? 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. First, let us simplify. 2 and 2 on both sides will get cancelled. So therefore, theta plus alpha is equal to 2n plus 1 into pi. Now this plus alpha on this side will become minus alpha. So theta is equals to 2n plus 1 into alpha plus into pi plus alpha on this side will become what? Minus alpha. So in this way we have got the solution of first part. Let us simplify the second part now. Now here this expression is in the form of what? Sine theta is equal to 0. So sine theta is equal to 0 implies that theta is equal to n pi. But what is theta here? Theta minus alpha upon 2 is equals to what? Keep this side as it is, n pi. Let us simplify it. Theta is equals to 2 will get multiplied on this side, 2n pi plus alpha minus alpha on this side will become plus alpha. So in this way we have got the second value of theta here. Both the value of theta satisfy are the solution of this trigonometric equation. Okay, so now we have to express both the terms in this form. Okay, so to express it in this form, let us simplify it. So let us see what we will get here. This implies that theta is equals to, okay. So now, here if we'll observe here, multiple of pi, is it even number or odd number? Definitely it is odd number, 2n plus 1. X represents what? Odd number. Already we have discussed on it. 2n plus 1 is what? Odd. When the multiple of pi is odd, at that time term of alpha is what? Minus. Or coefficient alpha is what? Minus 1. Remember that here multiple of pi is what? Odd. At that time coefficient of alpha is what? Minus 1. And here coefficient of pi is 2n. 2n means even or odd. 2n means definitely even. Agar pi ka coefficient even hai, to yaha pe plus alpha hai. Aur yaha pe pi ka coefficient agar odd hai, to yaha pe kya mil raha hai hume? Minus. So this implies that, can I write it in this form? So this implies that theta is equal to n pi plus minus 1 raised to power n into alpha, where n belongs to what? Z. So now from this or this expression, now we have to check whether this expression satisfies both the conditions or not. Now what is n? N is an integer. N is what? Integer. Agar n odd hai, तो यहाँ पे क्या आना चाहिए अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस रिजल्ट, अगर ये ऑड है तो अल्फा का कोएफिशिएंट क्या होना चाहिए, माइनस वन. सो कंसीडर एनी ऑड नंबर से थ्री, इफ द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ पाई is what odd number say 3, so here also we will get 3. So if I am replacing n by 3, minus 1 raised to power 3 is what, minus 1, and minus 1 into alpha is what, alpha means definitely whenever n is what, odd number, at that time we are getting this result. And if the coefficient of pi is what, even number, at that time let us check whether we will get this result or not. This result means what, if coefficient of pi is even, at that time we should have to get what here, plus alpha. So let us substitute here, n is any even number, say 2. If I am replacing n by 2, so here also replace n by 2, what is square of minus 1? So 2 means what, square. So square of minus 1 is what, plus 1. Plus 1 into alpha is plus alpha, means whenever we are substituting n is equals to what, odd number, we will get this result. And whenever we are substituting n is equals to what, some even number, we will get this result. Means this expression satisfies both the condition. That's why we can say that this is required general solution. So this is required general solution. So in this way we have got the general solution of this trigonometric equation. So now let us try to prove the next important theorem, theorem 3.2. In this theorem, we are finding the general solution of which trigonometric function, cos theta is equal to cos alpha. And we have to prove that its general solution is given by theta is equal to 2n pi plus or minus alpha. So let us consider the given trigonometric equation. Whenever we are solving the given equation, we are giving priority to find out what its factor. So this plus term on this side will become minus. Now terms are in the form of which formula, cos C minus cos D. So cos C minus cos D. And what is our factorization formula? Cos C minus cos D is minus 2 sin C plus D. C plus D upon 2 into sin C minus D upon 2. Here C means what? Theta. And D means what? Alpha. So let us apply this formula. According to this formula, what we'll get? Minus 2 sin C plus D means theta plus alpha upon 2 into sin C minus D. C minus D means theta minus alpha upon 2, and on this side is equal to 0. Keep it as it is. Okay. So now here product of these three number is equals to 0. And when we can say that product of three number is 0, means if any one of them is 0, means either first is 0 or second is 0 or third is 0. But first number is what? Non-zero. That's why here we can say that either second number is 0, means sine theta plus alpha upon 2 is equals to 0, or sine theta minus alpha upon 2 is equals to 0. Now we have got here two factors, and whenever we are solving equation, we are giving priority to what? Factorization method. And using this, we are trying to express the given equation in the form of these formulas. Now we can observe that here both the terms are in the form of which formula? First formula, sine theta is equal to 0. Sine theta is equals to 0 means apply the first formula to prove or to find out general solution. So what is that first formula? We know that sine theta is equals to 0 implies that theta is equals to what? N pi. So according to this formula, what we will get here? Theta. But what is the value of theta here? Theta plus alpha upon 2 is equals to n pi. In the same way, here also theta is equals to n pi. But what is theta here? Theta minus alpha upon 2 is equals to n pi. Let us simplify it. 2 is divided on this side. On this side, it will get multiplied. So theta is equal to 2 will get multiplied 2n pi, and plus alpha on this side will become minus alpha. Here also theta is equal to 2 will get multiplied on this side, so 2n pi, and minus alpha on this side will become plus alpha. So this implies that theta is equal to, now if you observe both the terms, here these two terms are connected by minus, and here both same two terms are connected by what? Plus, means which can be written as 2n pi plus or minus alpha, plus or minus alpha. And this is nothing but required general solution of this trigonometric equation. So this is required general solution. So in this way we have got the general solution of this trigonometric equation. Now see, in the third theorem we are finding the general solution of which trigonometric equation? Sin theta is equal to sin alpha, sorry, tan theta is equal to tan alpha, and we have to prove that its value is theta is equals to n pi plus alpha. So let us consider this trigonometric equation, tan theta is equals to tan alpha. So now we are trying to express this in terms of this formula, so that applying these formulas we are able to get our required result. Our maximum formulas are in terms of sine and cos, that's why tan we are converting it in terms of sine and cos. So tan theta can be written as sine theta upon cos theta, and on this side tan alpha can be written as sine alpha upon cos alpha. So which can be written as sine theta, keep it as it is, this term will get multiplied on this side, so means into cos alpha, and cos theta will get multiplied on this side, means cos theta into sine alpha. So now this plus term on this side will become minus. So see what result we will get. Sin theta into cos alpha. This plus term on this side will become minus, means cos theta into sin alpha. On this side remaining term is zero. Now if you will observe, this term is in the form of which formula? Sin A into cos B minus cos A into sin B, which is nothing but formula of what? Sin A minus B. So this expression is in the form of which formula? Sin A minus B. A means theta minus B means what here? Alpha. What is the value of sin A minus B? Sin A into cos B minus cos A into sin B. So which are called as compound angle formulas or addition subtraction formulas. On this side zero, keep it as it is. Now if you'll observe this trigonometric equation, so it is in the form of what? Sin theta is equals to zero, means is in the form of first formula. So according to first formula, what we can say? We know that sin theta is equals to zero implies that theta is equals to n pi, where n belongs to what? Z. So therefore, according to that formula, what result we will get? Theta is equal to n pi, but what is the value of theta here? Theta minus alpha is equals to what? N pi. So therefore, theta is equals to minus alpha on this side will become plus alpha, so n pi plus alpha, and this is nothing but our required general solution. This is required general solution of this trigonometric equation. So this is a required general solution. See, in the next theorem is theorem 3.4. We are finding general solution of which trigonometric equation? Sin square theta is equal to sin square alpha, and we have to prove that its general solution is theta is equals to theta is equals to n pi plus or minus alpha, where n belongs to what? Integers. Already we will have now six formulas. We are able to make the proper use of these six important formulas to solve this trigonometric equation. So first consider this trigonometric equation. Now to find out its solution or to solve this equation, we are making the use of one double angle formula. So let us revise that formula. Value of 1 minus cos 2 theta is equals to 2 sin square theta. So we are making the use of this formula, and using this formula we are trying to convert this equation in this form, that cos theta is equal to what? Cos alpha. So see what result we will get here. To apply this formula we will require 2 here, that's why I am multiplying both sides by 2. So therefore 2 sin square theta is equals to 2 sin square alpha. Just simply I am multiplying both sides by 2. Now according to this double angle formula, 2 sin square theta can be written as 1 minus cos 2 theta. 1 minus cos 2 theta. Instead of theta, on this side alpha is there. So 2 sine square alpha can be written as 1 minus cos 2 alpha. Now observe both the sides very carefully. Can I say that this 1 1 will get cancelled, because plus 1 on this side will become minus 1 and 1 1 will get cancelled. After cancelling 1, remaining term on this side is minus cos 2 alpha, and on this side minus cos 2 theta, and on this side minus cos 2 alpha. Minus minus will also get cancelled. So after simplifying it, result will be in this form: cos 2 theta is equal to cos 2 alpha. Now this equation is in the form of what? This formula, cos theta is equal to cos alpha. So we are using that formula. So first write down that formula. We know that cos theta is equals to cos alpha implies that theta is equals to 2n pi plus or minus alpha. According to this formula, what we will get? Theta. But instead of theta, what is the value of theta here? 2 theta is equals to 2n pi, keep it as it is, 2n pi, keep it as it is, plus or minus also as it is. Alpha, this alpha, instead of alpha, what is the value of alpha here? 2 alpha. Now, if you'll observe this result, all the terms on both sides are divisible by 2. If I'm dividing both sides by 2, here we will get theta, here after cancelling 2 we'll get n pi. Now in the theorem number 5, we are finding general solution of equation cos square theta is equal to cos square alpha, and we have to prove that its value is equal to theta is equals to n pi plus or minus alpha. So first consider the given trigonometric equation. So here also we are using double angle formula, that 1 plus cos 2 theta is equals to 2 cos square theta. Now already terms are in the form of what? Cos square. To apply this formula, we will require 2 here. That's why I'm multiplying both sides by 2. Same method we have used in the last theorem also. So cos square theta is 2 cos square theta is equal to 2 cos square alpha. Just simply I'm multiplying both sides by 2. Now we are able to apply this formula. According to this formula, 2 cos square theta is equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta. So here 2 cos square theta is equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta. And on this side, 2 cos square alpha is equal to 1 plus cos 2 alpha, applying same formula. After cancelling 1 1 on both sides, here terms are in the form of cos 2 theta is equal to cos 2 alpha. Isn't it? Now this expression is in the form of fifth formula, cos theta is equal to cos alpha. So apply that formula. So first write down, we know that cos theta is equals to cos alpha implies that theta is equals to, what is the value of theta? 2n pi plus or minus alpha. According to this formula, what we will get here? Instead of theta, value of theta is here 2 theta is equals to, on this side 2n pi, keep it as it is, plus or minus as it is. Instead of alpha, here value of alpha is 2 alpha. So replace this alpha by what? 2 alpha. Just we have substituted this value of theta and alpha in this equation, in this solution. So simplified, therefore theta is equals to, after cancelling 2 on both sides, see what we'll get. Theta is equal to n pi plus or minus alpha. And this is nothing but required general solution. This is required general solution. So in this way we have got the general solution of which trigonometric equation? Cos square theta is equal to cos square alpha. Again, now let us try to prove the last important theorem. Plus or minus, keep it as it is, after cancelling 2 here we will get alpha. So this is required general solution. In this way, we have got the general solution of this trigonometric equation. So now let us try to prove the last important theorem. In this theorem, we are finding general solution of which equation? Tan square theta is equal to tan square alpha. And we have to prove that its general solution is given by which formula? Theta is equal to n pi plus or minus alpha. So well, let us try to solve this equation. So we have considered first this equation. Nothing is in the denominator, means 1 is there. Just simply I am taking reciprocal of both sides. So on this side we will get 1 upon tan square theta is equals to, and here on this side we will get 1 upon tan square alpha. Just simply we have taken reciprocal on what? Both sides, isn't it? So now we are applying componendo dividendo. So try to understand what is componendo dividendo. If the ratio is in this form, A upon B is equal to C upon D, that it implies that A upon B is A plus B upon A plus A minus B is equal to C plus D upon C minus D. So such type of result you have studied in your earlier classes, ratio and proportion. So this result is called as what? Componendo dividendo. So according to this result, what we'll get? A upon B. A upon B can be written as A plus B, means 1 plus tan square theta, upon A minus B, means 1 minus tan square theta. On this side, it is in the form of C upon D. C upon D can be written as C plus D, means 1 plus tan square alpha upon 1 minus tan square alpha. Give here reason by componendo and dividendo. Okay, so now if you'll observe this term, it is in the form of double angle formula. Which double angle formula? Cos 2 theta can also be written as 1 plus tan square theta upon 1 minus tan square theta. Now according to this formula, its value is equal to what? Cos 2 theta. So here 1 plus tan square theta upon 1 minus tan square theta is what? Cos 2 theta. And here this term is nothing but value of cos 2 alpha according to same double angle formula. Now this expression is in the form of this formula, cos theta is equal to cos alpha. So write down that formula. We know that cos theta is equals to cos alpha implies that theta is equal to 2n pi plus or minus alpha. According to this formula, what result we will get? Instead of theta, what is the value of theta here? 2 theta is equal to 2n pi, keep it as it is, 2n pi plus or minus alpha. But instead of this alpha, what is the value of alpha here? 2 alpha. So both the terms, or all the terms on both sides, are divisible by 2. So if I'm dividing both sides by 2, here we'll get theta, here we'll get n pi, here plus or minus, after cancelling 2, here remaining term is alpha. And this is nothing but required general solution of this trigonometric equation. So this is a required general solution. So in this way, we have proved all the 6 theorems from our first article, which is our first article, trigonometric equation. In the trigonometric equation, we are solving the trigonometric equation and we are finding principal solution and general solution. So these are 9 important formulas to find out what? General solution. First 3 formulas are given as a remark, and this is our theorem number 1st, this is 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th. These 6 theorems we have proved here. First 3 theorems are given as an what? Remark in our syllabus. Means total how many formulas are there? Total 9 formulas are there to find out general solution of trigonometric equation. Applying these formulas, we are solving examples from our first exercise in the next video.